Hi guys, welcome back to Edgewood channel. So today in this video, we will be dealing with the culicoides, that is the biting midges which is belonging to the family Ceratopogonidae. So culicoides is the genus of the biting midges which is belonging to the family Ceratopogonidae. There are around 1,000 species, but we have to focus on mainly two or three species which is of veterinary importance. So they are called biting midges. Remember that word, biting midges. So this is the culicoides biting midges. So see the size difference. Yeah, this is a mosquito, this is the fly, and this is the midge. So midges are very smaller than mosquitoes and flies. So this is the adult female culicoides. This is the wing venation, etc. So moving to the taxonomical details. So the kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, and they all belong to the order Dipterans, and the suborder is Nematocera and family Ceratopogonidae. So moving to the morphology, they are actually the black or brown in color, very minute insects, and sexual dimorphism is seen only in the antenna. That is, you can differentiate male and female based on the antenna. In male, plumose is present. In female, pilose is present. So you have to be very clear with these words, plumose and pilose. Otherwise, no chance of any differentiation of male and female. So mouth parts are piercing and sucking type. So this very important point, that is, mouth parts are piercing and sucking type. And you have to just read about the wing venation. Yeah, that's important. So moving to the feeding habits, adults are the painful biters, and they are mainly crepuscular activity. That is, they will be active on the evening time. That is after 6 o'clock. Like something. Yeah, they are the females are the blood suckers, and they feed on human beings and animals. Males actually feed on plant juices. They don't feed on blood. And actually they will feed for around 3 to 10 minutes, so that time is sufficient for disease transmission. So moving to the life cycle, they'll be taking around 10 months to 12 months for the life cycle. Actual life cycle, you cannot even properly say this accurate day and month, because this depends on many environmental factors too. So egg to larvae, which will be taking 10 days nearly, and larvae to pupa, there are 4 stages are called 4 instars, and 4 instars will take 7 months. So the pupa to adult will take 10 days. So yeah, that's life cycle. So this is a life cycle. See, adults mating, feeding, gonotrophic cycle, egg maturation, oviposition, eggs are produced, developmental larva stage, then nymph, then moving to adults. So this is one more picture of the life cycle. So make clear about this life cycle. So this is the disease transmission and life cycle together, because the culicoides has a very big role in the transmission of blue tongue virus and African horse sick. So the pathogenesis is large number of biting midges will be coming together, and they will be causing serious irritation and annoyance to the livestock. They bite mainly in the head and neck area, and since they contain blood from many other infected or non-infected animals, whenever this biting midge is introduced to a new host, that can produce hypersensitivity to the serum sickness. So that may cause intense pruritic skin disease in the host, new host, called as seasonal equine pruritic dermatitis, which is very important feature on the culicoides. So the seasonal means it will be happening in a season, that is mainly in the summer, and it is also known as summer dermatitis. So there will be a wound, and the animal will be scratching the wounded area, and that lead to hyperpigmentation and skin thickening, that is self-inflicted trauma. So that more blood will come through the wound, that will attract more flies, etc. So it worsens, the situation worsens. It is called as Queensland itch in Australia and sweet itch in United Kingdom. So you have to be very careful with the summer dermatitis, Queensland itch, because it can come for any one-word questions and all. So the role as a vector. So they transmit viral disease like blue tongue in sheep and African horse sickness in the horses. And also the 3-day fever, that's the bovine ephemeral fever. And they has got a mechanical vector role in the transmission of onchocerciasis in horses and cattle. So this is the disease transmission cycle of epizootic hemorrhagic disease in the deers. That's the wildlife disease. Culicoides milt has got a very big role. See, Culicoides will be biting the wild ruminants and they will be circulating the EHD. And in sheep, they will be circulating the blue tongue. And in the cattle, they will be circulating the onchocerciasis. And in the horses, they will be circulating onchocerciasis and African horse disease. This is the life cycle. So control. So control is very difficult because they are very minute organisms. So we can use anti-midge rats, which are the sac-like things, which has got the insect repellent, that is citrus extract or neat, and control of larvae at the breeding place. Fans and anti-fly mesh can be used, and you should have to keep your horses in the stable at night. Don't allow them to go here and there. So thank you guys.